All right. Well, everybody, today is a day that perhaps people haven't been aware of from the listeners. Today is, it's not the last time we're going to hear from Verbs and Blake. I'm going to be clear about that. But it is the last time that this is, they are the permanent full-time hosts of Focus on This. Cue the,
Okay. You can just, on the YouTube, you could put the crying Jordan meme over my face right here, okay?
Hey, for you, I will.
Wait, I might have one. I'm doing the crying meme.
Oh, wow.
Oh, my gosh.
How do you do that?
Oh, my God. That was legit horror.
Verbs. It was scary. I scared myself. Wow. I second-guessed my decision right
really
when I clicked
something
that effect.
To Verbs. A part of him
absolutely
is dying today.
You're going to have to hop online to see that. But, well, here, I'll spare you. I want to get into the show here. But we, of course, couldn't do this and have this conversation unless we had the old clan back together.
Oh, no!
Let's go!
Yes.
Hopefully her computer cooperates.
Come on, AirPods.
Come on.
We don't. There she is.
Yes.
Yay. Whoa. Oh,
Courtney,
my gosh.
Courtney Baker has entered the chat, everybody.
Squad. I'm consumed with joy.
What?
Hi, Courtney.
Hey, how's everybody doing?
Wait, now I'm crying. I'm going to cry with joy. Here we go.
Don't do this again. Don't. This is so scary.
Courtney's back, y'all. She's back. All right, I'm going to stop. I'm scared.
That is scary.
It's like real horror film. Courtney, I keep saying hi.
Hi.
Welcome back to the show.
Yes. It feels so normal. It feels right. I miss all three of you. It is so good to see your faces.
Here's what we're going
to
do. So we've got Courtney here. We had some technical difficulties. We're going to push ahead. We've got Courtney. We've got Verbs. We got Blake. We're going to talk about what we've learned since the start of the show. And we're going to talk about
what worked and what didn't work.
And I feel like I should have said this before. There is a Focus on This happening next week. We will meet the new hosts. So that's all happening in this episode. And let's hit it, Verbs.
Welcome to another episode of Focus on This, the most productive podcast on the internet, so you can banish distractions, get the right things done, and finally start loving Mondays. My name is Verbs, here with Courtney Baker and Blake Stratton. Happy Monday to you both. Courtney, back in the mix.
Happy Monday.
Happy Monday unto you.
Courtney's here. What we're doing is we're going to celebrate and talk about the general, what have we learned? That's like the TV version of, like, if it were the 80s, it'd be an episode on, like, what have we learned? It might even be a clip episode, but I got to be honest with you, I'm not doing that. So instead, we're going to...
No, people don't want a clip show. Those are always disappointing.
I asked our three hosts here to think of two or three things that they've learned. It could be related to the show. It could also just be just a message of growth. Or things that they've learned since starting this show over 200 episodes ago, which is insane.
Dang.
A lot's happened since this show started.
Mm-hmm. So, a few things
have happened. So anyway, Courtney, let's just start with you, since we haven't heard from you at all recently. What's something you've learned in the last 4+ years?
Yeah, I think for me, the last 4 years. And I think I discovered this early on, but it kept being reiterated at deeper and deeper levels. But that productivity before this podcast really felt like a tactical, how to get just more done quickly. And over the last 4 years, I've really realized that productivity is actually a very deep journey, because ultimately productivity is about getting the right things done. And that's really hard to do if you don't know what you actually want. And so that's been kind of the culmination of great productivity is grounded in knowing what you want to pursue, And without that, it's just a lot of check boxes and getting more done, which can be helpful. But I think the real power for me is when those two things go together. I think that's been one of the most powerful lessons.
So important. So important. I recently saved a, I think it's a quote from Oprah. You know, people often compare me to Oprah, you know, having listened mm-hmm. to the show, they're like, oh my gosh, you're totally an mm-hmm. Oprah type, Blake. And so anyway, but she said, she has this quote where she essentially says what you just said, that one of the most important choices that you'll make or things that you can decide or learn is what you really, really want. And it seems like a simple question, but it can get profound and challenging in a hurry.
Verbs, over the last 4 years, lots happened. It's been a crazy time.
Yeah.
As you look back and look forward, kind of what's something that you're going to take with you that was going to help you reach the goals that you've set for yourself?
The last 4 years, I've had big ups, big downs. But I would say if I could kind of capture it all just in my time at Full Focus, one, obviously love the weekly preview. That's something I didn't have going on in my life before I got here. But just the idea of looking forward into your week and accounting for everything that needs to go in there really makes it what we always talk about, the secret sauce. So there's that. There's this idea of goals not only being something, you know, actions to accomplish, but really setting goals around who you want to become. And I believe Courtney alluded to that earlier as well. And I think really, again, kind of zooming even further out, there's a verse in the book of Psalms, and it says, teach us to number our days so that we may gain a heart of wisdom. And I think even just this whole Full Focus system that we've been talking about for the last 4 years and we'll continue to talk about really teaches us to number our days in such a way that we're stewards over our time, we're stewards over our energy and what we do with our days, how we work, how we care for each of our life domains. And through all of that, hopefully we're growing as people and we're gaining more life wisdom as we go along. There's going to be some things we get right. There's going to be a lot of things we don't get right. But I think when we have a system in place that helps us map it out, helps us reflect back on what might not have gone the way we wanted it to, but also a place where we can figure out how that can go better, then I think we're winning. So I appreciate being submerged in all of this talk and content and topics that we've discussed here on the podcast, because it's really helped me grow in new ways as well.
All right, great. Yeah, make me follow verbs. Real fair. Really fair.
I thought you already went.
Now I've got to feel all my feelings. I am tremendously grateful. I feel like I've gotten to do this a little bit, you know, last year when I sort of shifted.
Yes. But
it's worth restating. I have so much gratitude for being able to be a part of this small group right here and getting to be in your ears if you're listening to this or in your car speakers on your Monday morning. What an immense privilege. I was meeting with a new client that we just met last week, and I was just asking, how did you even find me on the internet? And he's like, oh, of course, you know, I listened to the podcast for years. Mm-hmm. And there are so many conversations that I've been able to have that start that way. And so for a multitude of reasons, very grateful. In terms of what I've learned, there's a couple things I thought would be worth sharing just as reminders or ideas for you listening. And probably the most profound thing that I learned is what rolling quarters were. That was pretty, pretty game changing.
What about like that index, walk. Though? What about that index?
I'm just kidding.
That index, y'all,
I still, 4 years later, I still don't use the index. Full confession. These are my confessions. Yeah. I still sing Usher on command, though. That is one thing. Two things that came to mind. One is that community creates consistency. I've done many different projects in my life, many different podcasts even. None have scratched the surface in terms of impact and longevity as this project has. And none have pushed me to continually dig deeper around a subject as much as this one has. And if I was just operating all this by myself, I mean, I may have hit 10 or 20 episodes, much less 200 plus. The team here has been amazing. And even beyond that, I've seen a huge difference in people who listen to the podcast or people who just get the planner and people who engage in our community or who have taken another step and engaged in community, whether it was Business Accelerator or other forms of community that we've had, or people that have been a part of my community that I host online. The just community is one of the most powerful forms of productivity automation that you can install. Mm-hmm. So that's been a huge learning for me. The second thing is an even deeper scuba dive, probably. But when I was thinking, if I only get an audience with these lovely listeners one more time, what is something that I would love for them to know? And it's something that I learned while we were recording this podcast. It started, I think, late 2019 when I got pretty sick. Do y'all remember when I got shingles?
Yes.
I don't know if you guys even remember that. I kind of kept it quiet. We were actually recording a podcast once, but I was dealing with, and this was starting, you know, back before I even worked at Full Focus, but very interested in productivity, but I still struggled with chronic stress and my health was taking, you know, was paying the price for that. And I think what I've learned over these years and am still continuing to learn is that time management is only partly about how well you use your time. I used to think that was all time management was about is, well, yeah, how do you make the most of your time? How do you use your time well? That's what time management is. But what I've learned is that there is a huge component of time management, which is how you feel or emotionally relate to your time, to your past, to your present, to your future. And it wasn't until I started to grab a hold of that, I think going deep into productivity and learning tools and realizing, oh, even if I check all these boxes or even if I get these things done, that doesn't necessarily, of course, it can help alleviate some things in the short term, but that doesn't necessarily protect me from burnout or help me process anxiety or even optimize my performance. I've got to take a look at this other side of time management. And so that's been a huge learning point for me. That's a very deep scuba dive. So if you lost oxygen there, you can go right back up to the surface. That's fine. But that has honestly changed my life. And I think being a part of this team and going deep into our tools at Full Focus have really brought me to that point in a powerful way.
It's awesome.
Courtney, I know that we were originally going to go one at a time, but such great thoughts have come in bunches here from Verbs and Blake. Did you have anything else that you wanted to share from anything that you've learned?
I mean, I really echo what Verbs and Blake both said. I would say the only other thing that I really feel as I look back on the last 4 years and I think is helpful for everybody listening is the emphasis on other parts of my life besides just my career or health. Like those to me before these 4 years felt very obvious. It felt like something I did kind of naturally. I was always like achievement oriented, but there are those other sides, like, you know, your spiritual life, your relationships, where you just don't think about the intentionality of, or even parenting, of creating goals and working towards those things intentionally. I mean, I think we always want better in those realms, but very rarely did I, before this podcast, make concerted effort towards those. And I think that that has produced some really beautiful change in my own life. And I think it's worth restating here for everybody listening to just encourage you, if that's where you fall into, where you always think about pursuing things in, you know, maybe work, health, maybe financial, you know, it's just those kind of more common areas, to really take a minute to spend some time thinking about how can I invest more, think more intentionally about, you know, those other life domains, like relationships, like your spirituality, and really make progress in those areas. For me, those were incredibly challenging a lot of times. Y'all remember when I was meeting with a spiritual director? It was like one of my goals. I don't know. That was really hard for me. It was a very hard goal, but it stretched me and it was so powerful on the other side. So I think that's another thing that as I look back was a really great tool in my own life.
Nobody asked me, which is fine. But I will say that the...
You're still on the show, buddy.
That's true. But I will say that the show, for me, I think that people who listen to the show know this, that I've had to really kind of come into a space where I can go, this is for me, right? Yeah. I am capable of being somebody who can like set a goal and set a path. And I don't know if that would have happened had I not been forced into a virtual room for multiple hours and then listening back and editing show. You know, I'm talking everybody, if you've listened to every episode of Focus on This, I've heard it at least twice. So take all of that and go, oh, some of these ideas have really started to filter in. So that's a direct result of spending time with the three of you. And so that's been very, very helpful. And I must say, nobody, even though I primed Blake and Verbs for this morning, nobody's talked about the dishwasher yet. So
I actually thought dun, about dun, that. Dun. Yes.
So that's the big takeaway for me is also.
Totally.
You're all using your dishwashers wrong.
Exactly. I think about that every night, you know, every night. Resetting my kitchen, I think about this dishwasher.
There are many highlights. I'm sure we could all point to. Guys, guess who we also need to send a shout out to from the very beginning? He was in the room with us while we were there in studio, is Larry. So big shout out to Larry. He was one of the pioneers as well.
Larry honestly walked through with us probably the darkest days of us not knowing what the heck we were doing. And I was always
factual.
So grateful for Larry because at the end of the episode, I was very insecure about my accent, about the way that I sounded. And Larry would look at me and just say, I don't want you to change one thing. Don't change one thing. Just be you and show up. And it was so powerful. And I am always so thankful to Larry for that. And now look, I'm on another podcast. What is happening?
Spoiler.
Fame.
Stop it.
I do want to point out, because I won't have this opportunity again, and it's come up on the show before, maybe, I don't remember, but the pandemic, for me, started with Blake and Courtney.
Yeah.
The pandemic was not happening yet until we were sitting in the conference room.
Yes.
Over the course of a morning, realizing, oh, they're closing this. And like Courtney freaking out. Going, this is kind of a big deal. Blake telling, it's not a big deal.
Yeah, I was like, this is going to be the hardest 2 weeks of our lives.
So I remember really vividly the day that Blake left the Full Focus office to go undertake his own work. And y'all, I cried. So I really cried. I was so sad. Thankfully, I didn't even realize at the time that I was going to get to see Blake all the time. Still, he was going to be on the show every now and then and still get to see him a lot. But even today, when I thought about showing up to talk to the three of you, I just thought, y'all are some of my favorite people. You are like the best of the best people. And that is truly... If there are any tears about to come, it's because I truly think you three are amazing. And if y'all just want to like get together and talk for like 12 hours a day, just like hang out, that's great. I'm down. But truly, I know we joked about the pandemic, but y'all really were like my pandemic people. And I'm so thankful that I had y'all in that season and the laughs and man, it was such a hard time, but y'all made it really doable. So anyways, I just thank you three for being so awesome. Like genuinely, I really appreciate each one of you.
Well, dang.
And that's it for our show. No, Courtney, we love you. No, the Verbs, don't Verbs.
No.
I love the show, man. I love y'all.
But real talk, I don't know how to follow that, Courtney. I feel, as I said, really grateful for the opportunity to be a part of it. But also, you know, I think that, and this is maybe a peek behind the curtain for those listening, the secret sauce of a lot of this productivity system and this company that produced this podcast, that produces the tools that you know and like, it is just the absolute high caliber people that comprise this group. You know, it starts with Michael and Megan and on down, but I've just been, even now, you know, as people have moved on to other things, it's like some of my most faithful supporters and encouragers, you know, Nick Verbs, Courtney, you being among them, are people that I got to know and meet here. And for you listening, it's, I don't know, I hope you take inspiration and comfort and continue on with this podcast, even after we're not here, just because the quality of people is just, I mean, such a high bar. And so I feel grateful to have gotten to be among this crew.
Yeah, I agree. Multiple times I've come on, we've logged on to record an episode, and I continue to be amazed by both. I mean, all three of you, obviously. Nick, he just comes in and does what he does because that's what he is. That's what he is. That's who he is, and he does what he does because of who he is. So thank you for being you, Nick. And then Courtney and Blake, like any topic could be thrown out there, and you all have the ability just to go and speak wisdom to it, as well as if it's a topic to where you're still learning, you're vulnerable about that and sharing that up front. So just being able to sit in this room with you guys, I've definitely learned a lot just about not only thinking about business, about thinking through this whole system, but just how all that applies to all of life, really. So I appreciate your guys' wisdom and your, again, your ability to just get on here and do what you do. So I'm going to do the crying face right now again. So flash the warning. No, but secondly, the last thing I wanted to say was, I mean, I'm grateful for Michael, Megan, Joel, just for entrusting us, especially as some of us have transitioned out into other opportunities, to allow us to continue to go as long as we did as representatives and voices for Full Focus as well. So there's not many organizations, you know, when your last day hits, you turn in your keys and all your passcodes and that's it. You know, we shake hands and depart. But I'm grateful that they allowed us to continue on doing what we've been doing here for the last, I don't know, year, some months. I don't know how long. When did you leave, Blake?
Last
year and a half ago.
May. Yeah. Wow. Yeah. Shoot.
So thank you, Full Focus. Thank you, Michael. Thank you, Megan. Thank you, Joel, and whoever else played a role in that. And in letting these ragtag kids stay around talking about planner stuff.
Okay, before we move on with the show, we thought it'd be nice to, people don't panic. I'm still going to be here, which is why you're all here on the show for sure. You're all here to hear what producer Nick has to say. But we are joined by the new upcoming host of Focus on This. You know him, you love him, you've seen him before. Marissa and Ken, cue the applause.
I feel like this is a very surreal experience, because I'm like looking at three friends, well, four, Nick, including you, but you're staying. Yeah, so we're not.
No.
And then it's like, this is the end of an era. It's really weird.
You're about to cry.
Don't. No.
I see.
I'm not going to cry. I'm not going to cry.
I'm already crying.
Stop it.
It really is a big moment. I mean, I think that you guys have carried this show for, how long has it been?
200 episodes?
3 years?
Yeah.
4 years?
Four. Mm-hmm. I was counting.
The pandemic, but it might have been right before. And so it's bizarre that you guys have taken, you know, our audience through all kinds of things in the world and through all different phases of, you know, our business and the Full Focus Planner. And then now we get to, you know, kind of send you on your way. I don't know. It's bizarre. It's really kind of crazy. I don't know how we're going to fill your shoes for sure.
Yeah. The way I like to think about it is, you left an amazing legacy, and we get to continue on that legacy with the current people and any new people who decide to join the Focus on This fans. But we're never going to replace any of you because you have a very special place in everybody's heart. I mean, if you ever look at the group, the Facebook group, they're like, where's Blake? Where was Verbs this time? Where's Courtney? Like, hey, it's called vacation. It's okay. Like, we're able to go at some point. But you guys all hold a special place in their hearts. And I'm specifically going to do a shout out to Courtney. Courtney, you hold a very special place in my heart because you brought me here to Full Focus. And we had a very fun and exciting time of on-ramping. And we've been texting each other back and forth here and there. So I appreciate you so much. And I know whatever you guys are going to do next is going to be amazing.
Yep. Before we talk about what's next for our crew here, I do quickly want to give Ken and Marissa an opportunity just to talk about like what you're looking forward to doing on the new Focus on This. Yeah. Like new Coke. That worked out well.
Well.
Did it?
Yeah, did it.
Y'all have made it such a
after
great
150
setup
years
us,
of this. Recipe.
Are they going to be good? Like, did it?
Well, we're definitely going to have to prove ourselves. I mean, that's the truth. These guys have big shoes to fill. I think that it's the same show, first of all, so don't freak out. You know, I jokingly said we should rename the show "Focus on That" instead of "Focus on This." But I think that there's going to be a lot that's the same. So for those of you guys who have been listening for a long time, you know, it's not like we're reinventing the show from the bottom. Obviously, we are going to have different voices. We're going to have different angles. You're going to hear a lot from our lives that we're going to be talking about. So I'm excited to share that. And I think one thing that Ken and I, as we've been kind of gearing up for the show and talking through, you know, content ideas, is we're super excited about widening the lens a little bit with Focus on This, to where we are able to really show more of our lives. We're really going to kind of give you guys a peek behind the scenes of goal achievement, whether it's with us or with our listeners, which we're super excited. We're going to be bringing some of you on from the community to talk through big goals that you're going through. So we want this to feel like this is your show. It's not just, for us, but it's for you guys, really. And so we're excited about that.
Yeah, I definitely know that there are, out of the 30,000 people who are in the Facebook group, there are so many fantastic stories of people using the planner or people just achieving some amazing goals. And we just want to share that with people. Because I think so many times people think about goal achievement as like, oh, well, yeah, of course they're doing it because that's all they focus on all day at Full Focus. Or, you think about Navy SEALs or these epic people, but like there are average people, right, who can actually accomplish great things every single day. And we want to start showcasing that more and more with at the same time talking about productivity and everything that we have been talking about. And we also have some new segments that we're going to try. Some of them are going to be amazing. Other of them may be epic
fails. I'm just going to give a little preview. Ken is trying to rope me into doing a 30-day CrossFit challenge.
Do it. Do it.
Yeah. Did you do CrossFit first?
Yeah, he's going to do it.
Well,
the old guard is trying to pass it.
Yeah, we're going to be doing different challenges and things like that to get out of our comfort zone and accomplish goals. And it's going to be fun. So we're really excited about it.
Yeah.
Well, I think it's an opportunity just to ask the old crew here. We have so many people in this room right now, this virtual room, especially Verbs. I think people may not realize this whole time. What are you doing now and what is happening next for our Intrepid 3 here?
Glad you asked. So currently, I serve at an organization here in Nashville called Rocket Town as a venue director. So basically what I do is we have a music venue, a music and event venue. So I just make my job is to make sure we get cool stuff, this family oriented entertainment and events that come into the Rocket Town space, as well as because Courtney said, I did have a music career, but last year we picked that back up. So we got music constantly coming and dropping on Spotify. If you're there on Spotify, Apple Music, Amazon Music, wherever you get your music from, make sure you look for us. And the group's name is Village King. Village King, King with no I, K-N-G, Village King.
And we'll put a link in the show notes, of course. Show description.
Since we have 30,000 people in the Facebook community group,
show some love.
Yeah, show some the Village King.
Verb, see those streams.
What kind of music? What kind of music is it?
Well, I'm a hip hop artist, so it is hip hop music.
Blake, What's the plan? What are you up to? What's next?
Yeah. These days I'm focusing on helping burned out leaders or leaders who are nearing burnout automate their productivity. So for those that have listened for a while, you know, I like to scuba dive, and that's a lot of what I do with folks nowadays. So I've developed some of my own scuba diving tools, if you will. I should probably clarify that's a metaphor. I'm not actually a certified scuba diver.
Have you trademarked?
But it's more the, some tools that I've learned over the years that have helped me recover from that or revive passion or vision and begin to automate progress towards that vision. So that's my focus nowadays. I do that in a newsletter. I have a community of folks I work with, and I do some one-on-one coaching as well. So yeah, if you want to hear about that, you can go to blakestratton.com, a website of mine, or fancy. If you're on LinkedIn, I share stuff on there almost every day.
And of course, Blake, are you still going to be around the community?
Yeah, still be around the community. In fact, I know I've gotten to know a lot of you actually over the last year just via Facebook messaging, or you've come to some of my free events that I host online. So that'll still happen. Who knows? May get into the podcasting game again myself. We'll see. We'll see what the people want.
Speaking of podcasts, Courtney.
Is that my cue for my update?
That's your cue.
Yeah. Well, for the last several months, I have been working on founding a new company. And actually, we just launched earlier this month to really help businesses navigate through AI, really looking at your organization from the highest level and really determine strategically how you're going to leverage AI. And it's such an important conversation, this moment in time, this new transformational technology, and helping executives do that really well. So we just launched our company called KnownWell. And actually this week just launched a brand new podcast called AI Know-How that's really going to be talking about, obviously the technology around AI is coming so quickly. There's so much to absorb. What we're really helping executives do is translate that technology into practical business application. And so if you're not tired of listening to me for the last 4 years, we would love for you to come join us over there. It's a little different vibe, but it's awesome. It's very fast paced. In 20 minutes, you're going to kind of stay up to date on what's happening in the world of AI. Did I think 4 years ago that I would be founding a company working in AI? No, I don't know what the odds were, Blake, on that one. But
well, you should have asked ChatGPT, and it would have told you
that
this nice. Was coming.
Nice.
I just subscribed. Here I am.
Thank you. If you would leave a 5-star review, I don't know.
Already done. I'm way ahead of you. Wow. I've literally already done it.
Use ChatGPT to create that review.
That's right.
Yeah.
Exactly. Yeah. So it's been really great. And I cannot think of two better people to be handing off this baton. When I was thinking about joining this episode, I just was like, can I even make it through like without crying? I thought Blake would be so excited for those tears. but also... Just so
feel
happy.
Your feelings.
I know. I know. I'm so excited for Ken and Marissa. I was like, Marissa, you filled in for me during the 4 years several times, including several months when I was on maternity leave. And I know Ken has had so much podcasting experience himself that you two are just going to do an amazing job. And I know our audience is in such great, capable hands, not to mention Nick. I'm excited for this, new era.
Yeah. Absolutely. Well, thanks. I'm really excited for all of you. I mean, I love that we, this is something that's really important to us at Full Focus, is we believe that we're stewards of the people, that we employ for the time that they're here. And we really want to leave people better than we found them. And you guys are such great examples of that. I mean, the fact that you guys are all doing such incredible business opportunities and really exciting creative things. I mean, it's just, it's really fun. And I cannot wait to keep up with y'all. You guys will have to stay in our community because the people are going to want to keep up with you guys too. And so, you know, share what you're doing. And, but yeah, we're really excited.
And I do want to say real quick that I, as far as I know, and I believe this is true for Ken and Marissa, that of course, if you're looking to be on a podcast to scratch that itch, you are always welcome to come say hey on the Focus on This podcast.
We love that.
You have not been kicked out and told never to come back, of course.
And that goes for everybody, all of you guys. You're always welcome. So,
for sure.
You know, I guess I feel like I should say this. I haven't really said it because I'm doing producer stuff. But I just want to say thank you to Verbs and Courtney and Blake. I might get emotional right now.
Don't
but I mean
do
this
it.
Little house, this
Don't
little home that you
it.
Built coming in. So I'm very, very appreciative for all this time that we've spent. And I'm actually really sad that we're not going to have this time anymore. We'll have to get together and pretend like we're making a podcast.
That would be awesome.
We'll have all the tech issues that we always had.
Yeah. Yeah. It'll I'll be show the up same 10 minutes as always. Late. It'll be perfect.
But I hope you guys come back. I will tell you this, that there is talk about finally doing a writing utensil showdown on this show after like 2 years.
We're
so
gonna
maybe
do that. We're gonna do it.
Maybe you could participate in that. And I know we'll keep in touch and all the other stuff. So thank you so much for all these years. This is crazy.
Yeah. So are we making thank this you. Outro extra dramatic? How should we do this, Nick?
Do I don't know. You want lightning in it?
Lightning kind of splitting of the oceans. You have your one side leaving, the other side coming in.
So thank you for joining us on Focus on This. This is the most productive podcast on the internet. So share it with all of your friends and make sure you join us at the Full Focus Planner community right there on Facebook. We won't be here next week, but Marissa and Ken, two powerhouses of podcast power, will be here ready with another great episode. So until then, and the whole house said,
Stay focused.
Always perfect.
It's a brand new day, get going to get the right stuff done. Focus on this. Focus on this. Happy Monday.
Here's a pitch. We like to make a podcast together. What if
we do a
reaction podcast to the original podcast?
We actually should do that for this.
that's very hilarious.
That's very popular. We really should. Right now. We can call it Focus it on That. And it'll just be a little secret. Well, we you know, it'll be not through Full Focus, but
it'll
we can just
a lot
respond
of maybe
to a podcast.
Like, what that's am fine. I even saying?
We can pause Why it and go, I really needed to like sneeze that? Then.
That it'll be a whole lot of that. What were we talking? What was even the question?